Terrell Owens has just called into the Rich Eisen show. How are you, T.O.?
I'm good. How are you?
You're on with Prime, too.
T.O., what's up, boss?
Oh, what's up, Prime Time? What's up?
You, man. You are up right now.
I know, man. I'm all, something's always going on with me.
So what's happening here, Terrell?
I don't know. I mean, I woke up, you know, yesterday to tweets and messages that Marvin Harrison had given an interview, and obviously he had some excerpts from that interview that he had done, and he was basically saying to hell with me and all this other stuff and quit complaining and this, that, and the other. But the thing is I never complained. I answered questions that were directed toward me during Radio Row, during the whole induction process. And again, I never complained. I just said, you know, I felt disrespected in regards to what the Hall of Fame was supposed to be about. And so again, I never said a bad word about Marvin Harrison. And I think there was an audio that I did where I mentioned some of the things that I guess the gun charge or what have you, but that was
that was in
regards to people saying stuff about character issues, and they mentioned Marvin Harrison, and so I basically kind of just chimed in on what had transpired with him in terms of, you want to talk about character issues, and that's what it's supposed to be, the Hall of Fame is supposed to be about.
Yeah, but that was it. I didn't know that was said. I'm sure that was what lit a fire up under Marvin Harrison's, because I knew that's not his character. So I knew it had to be something that he heard you say, or he assumed that you said, that was a direct shot at him, that he was retaliating. Now, that substantiates it.
Right. But like I said, in regards to that, there are a number of guys, I only mentioned that because the topic was, the subject was, that we were two receivers that were up for the Hall of Fame. And so, again, I mentioned other guys that have been inducted, and, there will be others that have had some off-the-field issues that fall under that category of character issues. And so that was my point in bringing that up. So other than that, I didn't feel like that was a shot at him. I didn't feel like that was me bad-talking him.
That's a shot.
Bad-mouthing.
T.O., that's a shot. I mean, I know you don't say it that way, but let me tell you something, my brother. And you know I've always told you when you're right, I tell you when you're wrong. To him, that's a shot. Now, if it's the same thing, and a guy like, let's say, Rod Woodson would say, well, Prime, I should be in there. Prime didn't tackle nobody, but I did that. First of all, I say, you're lying. You have no film to document that Prime didn't tackle. That's number one. Secondly, right. I would take that as a shot. So I can see how. I just want you to see how he could take that, if you're in his shoes, how he can take that as a shot towards him when you two are the receivers up that year, the highest ranked receivers up that year to go into the Hall of Fame in the first ballot. Not the first ballot, but going to the Hall of Fame.
Well, it would have been for T.O.
Would have been T.O. for T.O.
Would have been for you, T.O., for first ballot. So where do you think this goes from here, T.O.?
Well, I've already tried to shed light on it. I just left ESPN and I talked to Kerry. We did a live segment probably about an hour ago. And again, my point and of emphasis was this has, and whatever he may have taken from what I said, that was not, a direct insult at him. For me, my point was making that it basically addresses the flaw in the system of the Hall of Fame and the process. And so for me personally, this has nothing to do with Marvin Harrison. So when I woke up yesterday, I was kind of blindsided by everything as well. And so, again, I did a number of radio things during Radio Row, during the Super Bowl. I've done a number of interviews. So I didn't even recall saying it until they played it. So other than that, again, I don't have any problems with him. Never have. I don't even.
Yeah, you do now.
Having a conversation.
Well, you do now. I know you didn't, but you do now have a problem.
Well, I really don't.
Yeah, well, T.O., we was talking about you before you got on the phone, and Rich was asking me about you. And I really think you're one of the most misunderstood athletes in our generation, that people really don't know you. although you've tried to introduce them to her by a reality show, by even with several teams that you've played for. But do you think that's a fair assessment, that people really don't know you?
Well, absolutely. And I think now, we're in an era where, social media is really prevalent. And I think guys have used those platforms to really kind of dispel or dispute anything that may be going on with them. Again, I was at that era where I was kind of phasing out of the league when this started. So had I had that platform to do some of those things, I think that would have helped me in a lot of situations. Again, over my course of my career, there was a lot of scenarios, incidents that had happened where had I had that platform to do that, I would have. But my only defense in trying to do that was doing one-on-one interviews I did with you and other people or what have you. But again, the entirety of the interview wasn't disclosed. You know, it was edited and it was sound bites that really didn't show or didn't really show the real me, and it made it look worse than what it was. And so again, as you said, I tried to allow people in to understand who I was, but again, there was a lot of scenarios where I tried to do that, and it just didn't help.
Well, I hope this all gets smoothed out or smoothed over or whatever, because you and Marvin are going to be roommates for a very long time at some point.
Well, again, like I said, I tried to do the best that I could, and really explaining what I meant. I didn't really try to take a shot at Marvin. I basically was trying to shed light on the fact that when you bring up character issues, I never really had any character issues when you talk about inducting guys that have had, off the field incidents such as his. And so again, that brings up a character issue for me. So again, just because somebody doesn't like me, or there are things that, went on with the teams that I was with, then again, everybody's had issues. Everybody's had arguments with their teammates or disagreements. There are a number of guys that have, butted heads with their coaches, things of that nature. So I just fail to understand why when I did it, that it became such a big deal, and the media has basically unfairly criticized me and portrayed me in a light that, that calls now, like when something is said really minuscule, it makes it a big deal.
T.O., thanks for calling, and I
appreciate
it.
Appreciate you, man. God bless you, T.O.
Oh, absolutely, man. Thank you, man.
You bet. That's Terrell Owens.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern. On Audience.